My name is Anna Santos. I am the director of the Animal Blood Bank. And was started just out of the development of need for blood for our patients here at Georgia. So it started small and now has expanded to where it's at. So the donors are pretty much in-house. What I mean by that is they are somewhat related to the vet school community, which is a pretty big pool. So they're either students, staff, periodically they can be friends if they have a good understanding of what we do here. Well, first of all, they need to meet their size. They have to be at least 50 pounds. And they need to be healthy, of course. And they need to be somewhat behaviorally tolerable. They get handled quite a bit. We will sedate them if they're excited, but they have to be comfortable in the environment. And so if they're not, or if they show any signs of aggressions, then I don't use them. Blood therapy is utilized in a lot of different areas of veterinary medicine. It's not just if they have a massive hemorrhage and have lost a lot of blood. There's several other problems that they can have that they would utilize the different products. Majority that we do here is whole blood, packed red blood cells, and fresh frozen plasma or stored plasma. It's pretty expensive. The product, it varies obviously on the size and it can and the product, but it can go from $100 to $500 per unit of product that you're using. We use the exact same bags that we would use in a human donation, and there's a set amount of blood that you need to have in that bag because there's a anticoagulant and preservative in the bag, and you have to have the correct ratio. So we centrifuge it down and then we divide it out into the sizes that we want for that donation. I cannot keep up with the demand for plasma that the university needs. I can almost keep up with my red cells depending on what comes in. The biggest challenges would be, of course, to meet the demand, because what will happen is we'll have a big emergency and it's always over the weekend, they'll use everything, and so I have to restock the blood bank within a very short period of time and in hopes that I can get everything in before we need it again. We will have them come in, do a physical, TPR, have the doctor do a physical on them if they're going to be sedated. We'll set up our room, which basically is just a quiet spot with all of our prep, a gram scale, and our bag that we're going to donate into. We've got Bailey Coger. She is a chocolate Labrador, and she's a riot. She just does whatever you want her to, so she'll come in and donate for us.
About 6 months into it, talked to Anna, and Anna informed me about the blood donor program. So she, sort of a natural fit, just jumped in the program. It wasn't as much for the benefits of the free stuff, the food and the vaccines, as much as it was just she just enjoys coming to work, and that's only the real out to get her here. So that's what she does. I've actually brought her in on a few occasions for my own patients. Like after hours, I'll do a fair number of traumatic and non-traumatic hemoabdominal procedures where they maybe have a splenic mass or a liver lobe laceration, and I'll be the surgeon on duty. And if she hasn't donated in a while, I'll just run home, grab her for whole blood and bring them in and use her blood on those patients. It's just easier than calling someone else in when she's right there.